Hey guys, it's Delval. We're doing another Onimusha Warlords Achievement Guide. This time we're going for Ogre Savior, which is to complete the Oni Spirits minigame, which consists of 12 stages that must be completed in one sitting. Now as we go through this video, I'll refer to each weapon by the element it uses. So the very first stage, it's simple. You've got one enemy, and you've got to just straight, as soon as you start, focus them, take them out. As soon as you do that, you've got free reign to destroy the vases. Remember to pack up the herb, you never know when it's going to be handy. I had to use one a few times throughout this run, so I can certainly vouch for them. Now the second stage, you have 34 vases and you've got to destroy 20, and this time you have two demons to take care of. As soon as you start, make your way to the right one, hit it about 3 times or 2, just enough to stun it, and do the same to the second, and then pick up your lightning sword on the left, instantly switch so you can up your damage, and take out both of the demons, and then just at your own leisure, destroy everything. Now, on this level, there is two boxes. You'll want to pick up the one on the left for your sword, which you'll need, and the one on the right for the bullets, which you'll also need for a later level. Now, on stage 3, you'll have 39 vases, and you've destroyed 26. As soon as the level starts, instantly swing your sword, and keep walking forward. You'll run into a box in the middle, which will have your musket, which you'll need. Break the boxes behind that, and then use your magic move for your lightning onto the red knight. Turn around, destroy the vases, just to give yourself a bit of a better shot, and then use your musket to take out the flying blue enemy. And then turn around and finish off the red knight, should only take about 2 or 3 hits. At that point, it's all up to you just to destroy the vases at your own leisure. Now on stage 4, you'll have 38 bases and you've destroyed 26. Pretty simple one. As soon as you start, you want to attack the ninja on your left. I would recommend using the walk-on feature because it should only take about 3 hits. Then go diagonal to your right and take out the other ninja in the back right corner. And then, yet again, just destroy everything at your leisure. There is a box in the top left containing more bullets which you must pick up. And on the bottom right, there will also be a box containing your fire weapon, which you must pick up as well in order to complete the later levels. Now, on the fifth level, 36 vases, and you've destroyed 28. And this is the first tough stage. As soon as the level starts, open up your menu and switch to your fire sword, and use the lock-on feature to hit the red knight on the right side, and then walk up a few steps to hit the one on the left. Sometimes you will hit the floating blue enemy, sometimes you won't, don't worry about it. If you don't hit him with your magic attack, hit him with your musket. You know, depending if you haven't hit the vase at a previous level, because the bullets are quite rare. Make sure to kill the two red knights as well. Now in the sixth level, you've got to destroy 6 vases out of 6 vases. As soon as you start, run to the left. Make sure you hit the first two. The demon will take a swing at them. You don't have to destroy all 3 in the first swing. You can destroy 2 on either side and then go back and forth. But it's just easier if you can get all 3. On the 7th level, you'll need to destroy 32 at 39 vases. And this is the second tricky stage. This is why you'll want to make sure that your sword, your fire sword, had max magic. Auto lock onto the right one, and then use your magic to hit just in front of the red knight on the left and not hit him himself. And then use your fire attack again on one of the red knights to make sure they die instantly. Now, as I said earlier, don't be afraid to use herbs. And make sure that your fire sword does have max magic, so make sure to up that. And remember to grab the box in the middle as it is needed. Now on the 8th level, you have to destroy 36 out of 42 vases. As soon as the level starts, using your fire sword, hit the hobgoblin on the right and destroy the vase in the middle. Instantly switch to your wind-based weapon and use your magic attack in the centre of them. Walk forward a bit and do a second one. Now, at this point, you can choose to take out the enemies or go for the boxes. To be on the safe side, I decide to take out the enemies, just because the roll attack can destroy multiple bases really quickly and can screw you over in the level. Once enemies are dealt with, just deal with the bases at your own leisure. Now, here I thought I almost died, but I do put on the holy armor, just as a precaution, as the blue enemies do take HP rather than magic in this. Now, on stage 9, you'll have to destroy 28 out of 42 vases. As soon as the level begins, open up your menu and switch to your wind-based weapon. You'll want to get this slightly above half magic and make a rush straight for the enemy at the back, just to knock him over, and then switch out to your musket. You'll want to make sure not to miss and take out both float blue enemies, and then switch to your blue or your lightning weapon and use the magic attack to take out the goblin. Now, the box in this level is not necessary, so it's just an added bonus if you happen to miss with the musket in a later level, or an earlier level, not later. After you've, you know, dealt with the enemies, clear out the vases at your own pace. Now on stage 10, you've got 6 vases and you must destroy all 6, and it's the first kind of puzzle level. As soon as it starts, you want to bring out your musket and using your bullets, take out the 2 vases in front of you in order to destroy them before the Red Knight does. Now you can switch to burst shot and 2-shot the Red Knight if you feel safer doing that. I certainly do. Once you defeat the enemy, I recommend taking out your wind weapon and picking up the magic from him. Now once you move up a bit, there will be 2 ninjas that drop down on the left and right. You can then 2-shot them with your fire weapon and pick up the herb in the top right, just as a precaution. And if you stay far close enough to the top, the other ninja won't spawn until you move down a bit. Now on stage 11, as soon as it begins, you'll want to switch to your wind weapon again, which is why we wanted it to be max magic, there we go. Smash into about the centre, and make sure you try and hit the ninjas and the Red Knight as well. And then switch to either one of your magic weapons. I recommend the fire sword just because it does more damage. You can then either use the magic attack, which I would recommend to kill the Red Knight pretty much instantly, and then just destroy as many vases as you can. Most of the time the ninjas should be dead, but they can live sometimes, so just be wary. Now onto the 12th and final level, you must destroy 36 out of 44 vases. As soon as the level begins, switch to your wind weapon. This is why we wanted it pretty high left on the magic side. Smash a few vases as you begin, and then instantly use your magic in the centre to stop the hobgoblin at the back from destroying the majority of the vases with his roll attack. Switch to any of your magic weapons, I recommend the fire, just to deal with the other 2 large ogres quickly. At this point, just destroy as many vases as you can, and you should mostly have gotten all the vases using your wind weapon anyway. Once you complete the 12th level, that will indicate the end and your achievement will pop, and a small cutscene will play. Remember the save at the end of it to also unlock Unlimited Ultimate Mode. So hopefully you found this helpful, remember to like and share for a friend, and I will see you in later videos. Bye!